Hello and welcome. With the 2024.4 software release, we are proud to announce our integration of TyphoonSim into the greater Typhoon HIL Control Center software. With this comes several user experience and functionality upgrades, which we will be walking through in this video. TyphoonSim is a high-speed offline simulator developed by Typhoon HIL. It offers variable step simulation capabilities, providing flexibility for power stage and control design. Previously, it was available only as a standalone software, but from this release, it will also be a part of Typhoon HIL Control Center. Our goal with these new developments is to further our idea of model continuity, making a seamless transition from offline modeling to real-time HIL application. This also means that now, you have a single toolchain for design, testing, and integration, without the need for transferring or redrawing schematics. For users interested in the standalone version TyphoonSim, it will still be available for download on our website. Now, let's see how these changes impact the look and feel of Typhoon HIL Control Center. Let's begin by discussing the key simulation contexts which are now fully supported within Typhoon HIL Control Center, Real-Time, VHIL, and TyphoonSim. For each of these contexts, we will discuss the core library component and feature availability and visibility. Before this, let's talk a little bit about component and feature availability and visibility changes. To enhance user experience and provide greater insight into all available components and features in the real-time or VHIL simulation context, all components and features are now visible in the schematic editor, regardless of whether hardware or toolbox requirements are satisfied or not. Also, this means that you will be able to use Virtual HIL or VHIL Plus to check out all the features you may not currently have at your disposal for offline simulation. However, if there are any usage constraints for specific components and features, the software will display a visual notification. This is done by using icons and corresponding tooltips. This visual notification is realized on three levels: Library Explorer, Component Property level, and Model level. Now, let's see how these new changes impact your simulation workflow with a few examples. Let's go to Schematic Editor. Let's navigate to the Synchronous Machines section in the core library. By looking at this section, we can see that the three-phase permanent magnet synchronous machine with JMAG support has an icon next to its name. This particular icon is used to indicate the availability of this component in the real-time or VHIL context. Hovering over the component will open up a tooltip which can provide us with more information. We can see that this component is not available in the real-time context due to a missing device configuration, which provides non-linear machine support. Now, let's change our current device configuration in the model settings to meet the missing requirement necessary for real-time simulation. To do this, we will change the configuration of from our current one to a configuration which provides non-linear machine support. Once Library Explorer has been rebuilt, we can once again navigate to the library component and see that there is no longer any icon next to it. Now, let's take a look at the various icons that indicate the availability of components and properties. Here, we can see what the description for each of the icons is. From this, we can see that the equivalent set of icons can apply to components and features in case of both contexts. To confirm this, let's go to Library Explorer once again, to see how the same concept applies in the case of TyphoonSim. Here, we can see that now, we have two icons next to certain machine components. In addition to the icon relaying information regarding real-time simulation, we now have an icon which gives us the status of certain components from the perspective of TyphoonSim. Same as before, we can hover over the icon to better understand what the missing requirements are and its unavailability. We see that information is given for both contexts, and that this particular machine is currently unavailable in the TyphoonSim context but will be available in the future. As you can tell, we can choose to display information for each one of the contexts or both. This is done using perspectives, which we will talk about later. Let's see some more examples, this time showing how these indicators are realized on the component property level. Here, we've opened the properties of the half-bridge converter. In the Advanced tab, we can see the oversampling setting property, which allows us to choose between global and switch level GDS oversampling. Same as in the case of Library Explorer, icons will appear on the left side of the property name, but this time, we have two of them. Just as in the case of real-time or VHIL simulation, The same concept of icons and tooltips is applied in the context of TyphoonSim. In this case, we can see that this feature is currently unavailable in the real-time context due to missing requirements. On the other hand, due to its specific nature and its use in real-time as opposed to offline simulations, we see that this feature will be ignored in TyphoonSim. Same as before, meeting the necessary requirements will make the feature available in the real-time or VHIL context. For a model-level overview on component availability, we are also introducing a new type of model visualization. This can be particularly useful in cases where you are not the original creator of the model and need to understand the necessary requirements to run it. In this case, the model visualization feature helps you visualize the entire model according to component availability in a chosen simulation context, meaning that you can easily distinguish between components which are supported, not supported or ignored in a chosen simulation context, across the entire model. We can choose to visualize the entire model according to the requirements for each context. In this case, we will check out if the model meets the requirements for real-time simulation. We can do that by right-clicking anywhere on the canvas and selecting Visualize Model By and then Requirements using Color, Real-Time. To understand the coloring scheme which is applied to the model, you can refer to the requirements legend by selecting Visualize Model By and then Show Requirement Legend, or alternatively, by pressing the F9 button. One new addition which also helps us in better understanding of these requirements is the Model Information Window. The Model Information Window displays simulation perspective-dependent information on which model components are unsupported and which toolboxes are required to run a real-time, VHIL, or TyphoonSim simulation. To open it, you can click on the Model tab in the upper left corner of the Schematic Editor window and select the Model Information option. Alternatively, you can directly open this window by pressing the F10 button. In the Model Information window, we see that we have two tabs for both simulation contexts. In the upper half of the tab window, there is a Required Toolboxes field which displays all the necessary toolboxes needed to run the model in the selected context. Please note that here, toolboxes are categorized as required rather than unsupported. This means they will appear in this field even if you have already imported the appropriate license that includes the required toolboxes. In the bottom half of the tab window, there is an Unsupported Components field which displays all of the currently unsupported components in the given context. As you can see, hovering over the listed unsupported component will open up a tooltip which gives us information on why it is unsupported. Finally, we will discuss the topic of simulation perspectives. The simulation perspective chooser lets you focus on a specific context without receiving visual notifications from other contexts. You can find it in the upper right corner of the schematic editor window. There are three available perspectives to choose from: integrated, real-time, and TyphoonSim. In the integrated perspective, all components, properties, descriptions and constraints for both real-time/virtual HIL and TyphoonSim simulation will be visible. In the other two perspectives, this information will be shown only for the chosen context. If you don't have a linked TyphoonSim license, your perspective will default to the real-time perspective. To demonstrate, let's change our perspective from integrated to real-time and inspect the induction machines section of the machines library. Here, we will see that only real-time or VHIL relevant information is shown. Additionally, components which are unavailable in each context will not be visible in the core library in their corresponding perspective. Let's switch from the real-time perspective to TyphoonSim and check the library section once again. The same applies not only to the component properties, but also means that properties and property tabs will be removed if they are not a part of a simulation perspective. We can observe this by opening the three-phase squirrel cage induction machine. Here, we've switched to the integrated perspective. If we check the feedback tab, we see that we have support for using absolute encoder protocols, a feature often necessary in real-time simulation setups where precise position sensing and control are critical. What we can also see is that this feature will be ignored in the TyphoonSim context. Let's switch to the TyphoonSim perspective. If we navigate to the feedback tab observed earlier, we will see that, this time around, the absolute encoder property is removed. In this video, we've shown you the changes introduced into TyphoonHIL Control Center with the integration of TyphoonSim, as well as how to interpret and understand these new changes. Thanks for watching.
Check the video description for more resources on this topic, including how to download and get started with Typhoon HIL Control Center for free. You can also visit HIL.academy to access free courses, expand your HIL testing skill set, and get certified. Subscribe to our channel to get notified about new content.